It arrives like the spring, and like the spring, it too lifts the hearts. First we have the snowdrops, then the daffodils, then St. Bridget's Day, and then it's time for Six Nations 2013. Be still, my beating heart.
I wanna take you somewhere, so you know I care, but it's so cold and I don't know where. I brought you daffodils on a pretty string, but they won't flower like they did last spring.
It's the new Aviva, but it still echoes with memories. Do you remember this? This is the last bit of the old Lansdowne Road that's left, the last bit of signage. In the old amateur days at this time of year for Six Nations, the jerseys were taken out and washed, the boots were dubbined, and the new jars of wintergreen and Vaseline were bought. Oh, the innocence of it all. But of course, the professional era has changed everything. Just look at this extraordinary medical room here at the Aviva. X-rays, operating theatres, even a dentist. The professional era has turned what was once a casual three-month pilgrimage around the bars and the rugby grounds into a furious 6 weeks of intensity, concentration, and injuries. As ever, the Six Nations arrives with a whole series of different questions. First of all, can Ireland come out of a generation gap and create a new era? What of England, unlikely conquerors of the All Blacks? Have they got more in the tank?
And if somebody hurts you, I wanna fight.
What is coming out of France under their new coach? What vintage might they uncork? What of Wales? Disaster in the autumn and losing their World Cup seeding. And of course, Italy and Scotland. Are they just here once again to make up the numbers, or could this be their year? So let us recite the glorious mysteries. Jack Kyle, Michael Gibson, Willie John McBride, Tony O'Reilly, Ollie Campbell, Fergus Slattery, Tony Ward. Perhaps the most poignant question of all for the 2013 Six Nations. Will this be the great man's last hurrah? If so, let us hang out our brightest colours in celebration. The Six Nations overflows with memories. Championships, triple crowns, wooden spoons, knock-ons, dropouts. It's a place of gods and ghosts. Those six precious weeks in the springtime. Oh, great Oval Valhalla, coming your way right now.